Harry Potter is the third most grossing franchise in the world after Marvel and Star Wars. And I know that there's a lot of chaos going on about Wizarding World from the past few years. So in this video, I'm gonna break them down one by one. So let's start with Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. There is no official announcement about the movie yet, but there have been strong rumors that there will be a movie of Harry Potter and the old cast is making a return in this one. And I expect that it almost gotten us. The Deathly Hallows Part 2 is probably the last story in Harry Potter's timeline, meaning that Harry Potter 9 won't be happening. Speaking at the Broadway opening of Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, J.K. Rowling said she doesn't expect to continue moving the story forward by creating a Harry Potter Book 9. Instead, she said that it's time for the Harry Potter's children to take the cape off from Harry Potter. Where is Fantastic Beasts 3? The spin-off series of Harry Potter, which was prior to Harry Potter. Some of you might already know that there are meant to be 5 Fantastic Beasts sequels, of which 2 we already know. Originally, these films were meant to follow suit, with the first 2 coming out every 2 years following the same pattern we should have gotten. The third installment in the November of 2020, then fourth in November of 2022, and lastly fifth in November of 2024. However, things clearly didn't go exactly according to plan and they are behind schedule. And now it is delayed to 14th of July 2022. What's going on with Fantastic Beasts 3? Negative reviews and weak box office receipts of the whole series was something which Warner Brothers noticed quite suddenly. Raising serious concerns about their plans to launch 5 series of spin-offs, Warner Brothers has now shown a great deal of confidence in giving the third series with a great deal of effort not to replicate the fate of the previous films for now. It was initially meant to hit films last year, as I mentioned earlier, but was pushed back because of a change in the script. But I'd much prefer that they take longer to produce quality movies rather than spotting them off as quickly as possible, this new approach. Actor Dan Fogler, who plays Jacob, has publicly expressed that the third movie will be more significant than the first 2 movies combined, which is exciting. They seem to be taking their time so that they can give us a quality product. Rowling herself has expressed that she now has an incredible vision of where she wants to go with the series and has already finalized the revised screenplay. Will Johnny Depp return as Grindelwald in the third installment? You all are well aware of what's going on with Depp and his ex-wife Amber Heard. In a statement posted to his Instagram on November 6, 4 days after the conclusion to his libel case, he wrote in a typed letter, "I wish to let you know that I have been asked to resign by Warner Bros. From my role as Grindelwald in Fantastic Beasts, and I have respected and agreed to that request." So it's clear that he will not be seen as Grindelwald again. But he is one of the major and brilliant actors who can play any role assigned to him, and without him in the sequel may lack people's craze in Wizarding World. Will Harry Potter returns in Fantastic Beasts? The timelines of both Fantastic Beasts sequels are followed as Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them in 1926 and Crimes of Grindelwald in 1927, and Harry Potter was born in 1980. So there is a 50-year gap between the timelines. And if J.K. Rowling wished to cover Harry Potter in upcoming 3 spin-off sequels, then maybe we can see the cameo of baby Harry Potter and how his parents were killed by Voldemort. So it would take a major flash forward from the final movie for the timeline to connect with Harry Potter. According to the New York Daily News, the movie studio wants to get a film adaptation of the story on the big screen ASAP, and furthermore, they want Daniel Radcliffe to reprise his role as Harry Potter. Hagrid and Tom Riddle, who would have been on the Hogwarts grounds during the years the films were set. Tom Riddle starts off Hogwarts in the year 1938 and Hagrid in the year 1940, which fits the time frame if Warner Brothers and Rowling are hoping to re-inject some of the magic back into the films. Where do you think the cameo of Harry Potter fits well in timeline of Wizarding World movies? Let me know in the comments. And do like, share and subscribe for more fantasy in games, movies and shows.
Voldemort, it is not our abilities that show what we truly are. It is our choices.